एवरीवन, दिस इज चेतन सिंघल. वेलकम टू माय चैनल स्टार्ट शाइन, वेयर नॉलेज शाइंस टू मेक यू शाइन. इन दिस वीडियो वी विल बी लर्निंग डिफरेंट प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ मीन एंड वेरिएंस. सो इन माय अर्लियर वीडियोस आई हैव एक्सप्लेन्ड अबाउट मीन एंड वेरिएंस, सो प्लीज चेक दैट आउट फर्स्ट इन द लिंक्स गिवन बिलो. सो कंसिडर आवर डेटा x1 x2 टिल xn. सो वी हैव n ऑब्जर्वेशंस. सो मीन इज डिफाइंड एज x bar equals to summation xi upon n. Here I goes from 1 to n. That is nothing but sum of all observations divided by n. Now, property 1. So, consider yi equals to xi plus a. So, what we have done here is we have added constant to all these observations x1, x2, xn, and we have denoting it by yi. So yi is equals to xi plus a. So now we want to calculate the mean of yi, which is nothing but summation yi upon n. y1 plus y2 by n. It equals to x1 plus a, x2 plus a, and xn plus a upon n. So if you see, you just collect these x terms, and this a, if you see, will occurs n times because we have n observations upon n. So if you see, this is summation xi by n plus n a by n. This is nothing but summation of xi by n. So this is x bar plus a. So y bar equals to x bar plus a. So what does property 1 says? That if we add any constant to these observations, then the mean of the new series that we get is increased by a. So this is the first property. Now coming to second property. Now suppose we have multiplying each observation by a constant. This is nothing but axi. So now we want to calculate the mean of y bar, which is nothing but summation yi by n. Summation. So just instead of yi, put axi, and it goes from 1 to n. So a is constant. So this is nothing but ax1 plus ax2 axn by n equals to a summation xi by n equals to ax bar. So what does this property says? That if we multiply each of these observations by a constant a, then the mean, new mean, the mean of new observations, that is also multiplied by a. So y bar is nothing but a into x bar. X bar is the old mean and y bar is the new mean after getting the observations when multiplied by a. So this is our second property of mean. Now coming to third property. So suppose we have two data. Data 1 and data 2. It has n1 observations, n1, and it goes like x1, x2 till xn. 1. And it has n2 observations, y1, y2 till yn2. So if you denote x bar, it would be summation xi by n1, and y bar equals to summation yi by n2. So now what you did is you combine both the data set. You combine data 1 and data 2. You combine them. So you have now new set of data, new data, which has n1 plus n2 observations, and the data is something like x1, xi's and yi's. This and this. So now we want to calculate the mean. So let we say that new mean, what it would be? It would be sum of all observations, which is summation xi plus summation yi upon total number of observations. So total number of observations is n1 plus n2. This is nothing. So if we see summation xi, this is x bar into n1. So n1 x bar, summation yi is nothing but n2 y bar upon n1 plus n2. So this is nothing but a linear combination of x bar and y bar, which are the means of our individual data series. So this is again one of the property of mean, that if we combine the two data sets, then the new mean that would be that we would get is the linear combination of the individual means of the series. So this is the third property of mean. Now we'll start with the properties of variance. We denote it by sigma square, and it's written as summation xi minus x bar square. So first property, so yi equals to xi plus a. So we are adding a constant a to each of these observations to get new observation yi. So we want to calculate the variance of selected x, and sigma y square equals to 1 upon n summation yi minus y bar. So this is nothing but 1 upon n summation yi is nothing but a plus xi. And just before that we see that the new mean y bar would be nothing but x bar plus a. So in this video only we just see that if we add a constant to each observation, the mean is increased by that constant. So this is nothing but minus a minus x bar ka square. So this is equals to 1 upon n summation I goes from 1 to n xi minus x bar square equals to sigma x square. So what does this property says? That if we add any constant to the each of these observations, then our variance remains the same, right? So this is a very important property of the variance. And then we just multiply each of the observation by constant. So in this case, let's see what sigma y square. So y bar mean is nothing but ax bar, as we have seen earlier in this video. This is summation I goes from 1 to n 1 by n yi minus y bar square. So this is nothing but 1 by n summation I goes from 1 to n. This is a into xi minus a x bar square. This is 1 upon n a square summation I goes from 1 to n xi minus x bar square. This is 1 upon a square by n. So a square, and this is sigma x square. Yeah, so new sigma y square is a square times sigma x square. So if you see, if you multiply each observation by a, then the new variance would be multiplied by a factor of a square. So we have to remember that it is multiplied by a square and not just a, because mean is multiplied by a, but the variance of the new series is multiplied by a square. If we do sigma y, which is the standard deviation, this is a times sigma x, and here it remains the same. So these are the two properties of variance. Now we will just break down this formula into a simpler format. Sigma x square equals to 1 by n. So we'll open the square. A square plus b square minus 2ab. Right? So this is 1 by n, and we'll take the summation inside. This is summation xi square plus summation, sorry, this would be x bar square. Summation x bar square minus summation 2 xi x bar. Right? Now it would be 1 by n. This is summation xi square. It would remain as it is. See, x bar is independent of I. So it would be at n times. So this is nothing but n x bar square. And this 2 into x bar is also independent of I. So we'll take 2 x bar. And here it would be summation xi. And summation xi is nothing but n x bar. As our x bar is nothing but summation xi by n. So here it is 1 by n summation xi square plus nx bar square minus 2x bar nx bar. So this is nx bar square, this is 2nx bar square. So it is nothing but 1 by n summation xi square minus nx bar square. So this is the formula for variance which we have broken down to this format. Because for calculation purposes, we'll be using this formula. So we just take n inside, so it would be summation xi square by n minus x bar square. And what would be sigma x? Sigma x standard deviation would be nothing but under root of this value. Sigma x would be under root of summation xi square by n plus or minus x bar square. Right? So this is the formula for standard deviation and variance. So suppose now we have frequency data. Frequency data is nothing but x and f. So suppose our data point is 1 and it is occurring 2 times. So suppose I have data is 1, 1, 2, 2, 3. So 1, 2, 3. So this is nothing but our frequency data. 1 occurs 2 times, 2 occurs 2 times, and 3 occurs 1 time. So this is frequency. So suppose we have data in this format. Then what would be the formula for variance? It would be same, but the only change what would happen is here. We'll just multiply it by f. Sigma x square would be summation f xi square upon n. N is nothing but total number of observations. Here n is 5, not 3, because we have 5 observations. So this is nothing but summation of fi. Summation of fi and minus x bar square. X bar would remain the same. So if we denote what we can write x bar, x bar is nothing but summation fi xi by summation fi. So this is the formula for variance in the term of frequency data, right? So in my upcoming videos, we'll be calculating variance for different cases and mean also for different cases using different methods. So stay tuned and try to understand these mathematical formulas. And if you like the video and the content, please like my video and please subscribe to my channel. Keep shining. Thank you.